This tutorial will demonstrate the steps required to set up a full disk and partition image backup plan using the Seagate Black Armor Backup application. To get started, launch the Black Armor Backup application using the icon placed on your desktop during the Black Armor Discovery software installation. You can also find a shortcut to the application in the All Programs Seagate folder. Once the application's splash screen displays, click on the Go to Main Screen menu link. Then, on the Add Backups page, select the Disk and Partition Backup link. The Disk Backup page displays a list of all the drives and their partitions that are connected to your computer system, as well as a list of destination drives. The first step is to select the drive partitions you'd like to back up by putting a check mark in the corresponding checkbox. Next, select a destination for your backup. To select an alternate destination than the one shown, first click on the drop-down box arrow button. Then select a destination from the list or use the Browse feature to find the destination drive of your choice. To continue the backup plan setup, click on the Disk Backup Options link at the bottom left side of the screen. Once the Disk Backup Options page launches, the Advanced tab displays by default. We'll go through and explain each option on the four Disk Backup Options pages, starting on the Advanced page. Clicking on the down arrow buttons next to each of the titles will display the choices available for that option. First, we'll look at the image creation mode. By default, the program copies only the hard disk sectors that contain data. However, you may select to backup your drive using the sector-by-sector method. When performing sector-by-sector backups, unallocated space is not included in the backup file. To include unallocated space in your backup, put a check in the Backup Unallocated Space checkbox. Next, Backup Protection Options. To protect the backup, enter a password for your plan. To increase the security of your confidential data, you can encrypt the backup with strong industry-standard AES algorithm. Click on the Encryption Method drop-down menu and select an encryption key from the list. Next, Pre- and Post Commands. You can specify commands or even batch files that will be automatically executed before and after the backup procedures. Please see the Black Armor Backup Help pages for further information on this option. Next, backup splitting. Backup splitting allows you to split your backups into several files that together make up the original backup. The default for this parameter is set to automatic. To change the parameter, first click on the drop-down menu. Then select the type of splitting you want to use from the menu list. Next, validation settings options. When the validation option is enabled, the program will check the integrity of the recently created or supplemented backup version immediately after backup. When setting up a backup of critical data or a disk and partition backup, we strongly recommend that you enable this option in order to ensure that the backup can be used to recover the lost data. To enable validation, put a check in the Validate Backup When It's Created checkbox. You can also schedule validation of your backups. To change from the default of validating immediately after the backup has completed, first click on the Regular Validation link. A Schedule Your Operation dialog box will display. Make the changes to the schedule that you wish. When you've finished, click the OK button to continue. Next, the Backup Reserve Copy feature. From here, you may select to create a reserve copy of your backups and save them to any available backup location. To make a reserve copy, first put a check in the Create a Reserve Copy of My Backups checkbox. Then click on the Set Location link. When the pop-up dialog box launches, specify a destination for the backup copies from the locations available to you. When you've finished, click the OK button. You can also protect the backup reserve copy with a password. To do so, first click on the Set Password link. Then enter the password you wish to use in the spaces provided. When you've finished entering your password, click the OK button to continue. Next, we'll look at screenshot settings. Along with backup comments, screenshots help you to recognize a previous data state that you may need to recover. Black Armor Backup allows you to take screenshots at the moment of starting a disk or partition backup. To enable the option, select the Take Screenshot checkbox. Next, we'll review the error handling parameters. If the program encounters an error while performing a backup, it stops the backup process and displays a message and waits for a response on how to handle the error. If you set an error handling policy, the program will not stop the backup process, but will simply handle the error according to the set rules and continue working. Select any of the policies you wish to use by putting a check in the appropriate checkbox. Next, computer shutdown setting. If you know that the backup process you are configuring will take a while to complete, you may select to have the Seagate Black Armor application shut down the computer after the backup is finished. The program will perform the backup, then turn your computer off automatically. To take advantage of this option, put a check in the Shutdown Computer checkbox. Next, we'll explain the different backup scheme choices available to you. To continue, click on the Backup Scheme tab. Backup schemes, along with the scheduler, help you to set up your backup strategy. The schemes allow you to optimize backup storage space usage, improve data storage reliability, and automatically delete obsolete backup versions. To select a backup scheme, click on the Scheme drop-down menu and select the scheme you wish to use from the list. Next, performance options. On the Performance tab, you can configure the following settings: compression level, operation priority, and network connection speed limits. First, compression levels. You may choose the compression level for a backup by using the slider bar. Please see the Black Armor Backup Help pages for further information on this option. Next, operation priority. Changing the priority of a backup or recovery process will make it run faster or slower. Decreasing the operation priority will free more resources for other CPU tasks. Increasing backup or recovery priority may speed up the process by taking resources from other currently running processes. Use the slider bar to set the priority setting that you wish to use. Network connection speed. You can specify the network backup data transfer speed limit by putting a check in the Limit Transfer Rate checkbox, then select a speed from the drop-down list. Next, notifications. Black Armor Backup can notify you via email when it has finished or when the free space on the backup storage becomes less than the specified threshold value. To be notified by email when these events occur, put a check in the appropriate checkbox and enter your email account information in the spaces provided. When you've completed selecting the settings and parameters from all four tabs, click the OK button to close the pop-up dialog box and return to the disk backup page. Once you've set all the parameters for your backup, click the Backup Now button to start your plan running. Your backup plan will begin running. This concludes the Seagate Black Armor Backup tutorial. Please view the rest of the Black Armor Business Edition tutorials for more information on the product and features.